Good morning, Richmond High. Today is Monday, March 15. My name is Jessica Contreras, and I'm here to bring you the Richmond High Weekly News. Students, the last day for teachers to submit quarter two changes for incompletes is Friday, March 19th. Make sure you've spoken to your teachers and submitted necessary work to earn passing grades. And staff, please remember that the College and Career Center Mixer is this Friday at 1:30 p.m. Details, including the Zoom, have been emailed. Estudiantes, el último día que tienen los maestros para cambiar los grados incompletos es el viernes 19 de marzo. Asegúrense de haber hablado con sus profesores para asegurarse de que tengan una calificación aprobada. El personal, recuerden que el mezclador del centro universitario y de carrera es este viernes a la 1:30. Los detalles, incluido el Zoom, han sido enviados por correo electrónico. On this week's news, Anton Whitley, a Kennedy High School 11th grader, went missing on Wednesday, February 10th, near the San Rafael Bridge after voluntarily exiting a rideshare vehicle. Anton's family meets every day at 3 p.m. at Main Avenue and Marina Way South to distribute flyers and create awareness. If you or anyone you know has information about Anton, please contact Detective Chris. Here is his phone number, his email, and you could also follow at find.anton.whitley for more information and ways to help. En las noticias de esta semana, Anton Whitley, un estudiante de la escuela secundaria de Kennedy, desapareció el miércoles 10 de febrero después de salir voluntariamente de un vehículo de viaje compartido. La familia de Anton se reúne todos los días a las 3 p.m. en Main Avenue y Marina Way South para distribuir folletos y crear conciencia. Si usted o alguien que conoce tiene información sobre Anton, comuníquese con el detective Chris Palma a este número y a este correo electrónico. También puedes seguir a este en Instagram para más información y formas de ayuda. That's all we have for announcements. Coming right up, take a look at what our students are up to during distance learning.
On this morning, I woke up at 7:50. Not very happy about that. Get my bed, brush my teeth, wash my face. Did a sandwich bomb. Did my hair amazing.
March Madness. Consider joining the College and Career Program. All programs are still recruiting for the year. CIR is recruiting 9 and 10th graders. Upper Bound Berkeley and Mills is recruiting 9th through 11th graders. PAC is recruiting 11th and 10th graders. And EALP is recruiting 9th and 10th graders. The interest form link is http://bit.ly/joincmcprograms. You can also scan the QR code on the screen to get to the interest form. Watch the video link on the interest form or click through the Google slides to learn more about the requirements for each of the programs. We can't wait to continue to support you and all of your college and career goals. Calling all Contra Costa Bound seniors. The second workshop in the enrollment series, Enrollment and Orientation, is tomorrow, Tuesday, March 16 at 3:30 p.m. Register at https://bit.ly/2021-ccc@ if you haven't already done so. Make sure you have verified your email after you apply and have your inside portal login for the workshop. Your CCC application should already have been submitted. If not, submit as soon as possible.
Spring is when there are tons of scholarship deadlines, especially for seniors. Join the College and Career Center staff at Cash Out Wednesday every week at 3:20 p.m. to learn about scholarships, upcoming due dates, and get help with completing them. RSVP using the link provided. Hope to see you there. Congratulations to Brisa Aguayo Ramirez for her admission to UC Berkeley, Chico State, San Jose State, the University of the Pacific, and Cal Poly San Luis Obispo. Way to go, Brisa. Class of 2021, submit your acceptances using the link provided so we can celebrate you too. The LGBTQ Plus Club is looking to gather more members. This club meets every Thursday at 2:30. If you identify as LGBTQ Plus or an ally, please join us. Reach out to Mr. Romero for more information. Hope to see you there.
Hi, my name is Ella Lupe. I'm an oiler crew leader. I'm making this video because, you know, life is stressful nowadays and, you know, beforehand and every day is stressful. A way to combat such stress is to avoid procrastination. Pacing out your work so you don't stress out too much is, in fact, important because then you're up at 3 a.m. trying to get all your work done before it's late. Or you have a bunch of late assignments and you're trying to get them done before the quarter ends. And that's not necessarily good for your mental health. And your mental health is, in fact, tied to your physical health. And, you know, you don't want that going down the drain. I know this is easier said than done, as you can see by my many tabs that I have open. But, you know, there's ways you can help remind yourself, such as setting up a schedule or lying to yourself, saying that the due date is either a day or a couple hours before the actual due date so that you get it done on time. Another way to de-stress that's important is self-care. You need to remember to take breaks. Sorry, my birds are going off if you can hear them. Take breaks while studying or doing your work because, you know, you might get stuck and or frustrated, and like just taking a step back and getting a breath of fresh air will, you know, help you refocus yourself. And don't forget to take basic care of yourself. You know, like sometimes you're just like way too into what you're doing and you'll just forget to eat or drink water or even go to the bathroom. You're just like holding it. Like, don't do that. Also sleep. You need sleep. You can't be up till like 3 a.m. doing work. Also get your work done just like at a timely manner or as fast as you can so you can just have time to sit back, relax, and enjoy what life you have, I guess. That's about all I have to say. If you are one of my freshmen, and now's the time for me to beg you to follow this Instagram, please, and thank you at @AG_OilerCrew. It's one of the ways you can contact us also. And if you're not one of my freshmen, don't be afraid to talk to your oiler crew leaders. That's what we're there for, to help you guys. Same thing goes with your teachers. Yeah, that's all I gotta say. Bye.
Hey guys, what's up? Oiler leader Ashley here, and I just want to talk to you guys about a struggle I had during freshman year and how I overcame it. So let's start. So one struggle I had was I was playing volleyball, which, as you can see in that corner right there, everyone knows the anime. Come on now. If you haven't watched it, watch it. Really cool. But I was playing volleyball, and I made it varsity, of course, and not flexing or anything, but our games would usually start like 7, or our practice would be hecka late. And by the time I got home, I was so lazy to do my homework that I didn't even start on. So I'd be staying up, doing my work, and then the next morning when I had to go to class, I would be so sleepy and not even listening. And in sophomore year, I was like, this gotta change, you know? I gotta start sleeping early, getting enough rest. So I decided to start doing my work before practice and before the game started, so like when JB was playing. And that helped a lot because by the time I got home, you know, I could just go to sleep, worry about nothing. And that helped me academically a lot. And some advice I would give you guys is to keep a positive mindset. Like, throw all those negative thoughts out because those aren't going to help you. You know, with a positive mindset, you go anywhere. And another advice I would give you is don't get distracted, because when you're trying to finish your work, and your phone's right next to you, and you get a notification, you know what's going to happen. So at least silence your phone when you're trying to finish work. And to manage your time well, because if you're not going to manage your time, then you're just going to procrastinate and leave it till last minute, and then you're not going to turn it in on time, and that's going to affect your grade a lot. And last of all, to get enough rest, because rest is everything, guys. Even if it's online school and it's a little later, you know, you still want to have your full focus during class. So if you guys have any questions, or you guys want to talk to someone or need more advice, you know, you guys could hit me up on that Instagram down there. That's my older leader account, dream.2.team. And yeah, I hope you guys are surviving. Stay safe. Finish strong. You guys are almost done. And hopefully next year, you get to have that real high school experience. Bye.
That's our show for today. Tune in next week for your Richmond High weekly news. Adios, Richmond High.